Hello. Thank you for your question. And it's lovely to be here. The main message of my new book, 2012 and Beyond, is that we're living in the most awesome time. 2012 offers the greatest opportunity for spiritual growth that there has ever been in the history of the planet. Beings from other universes and star systems are watching in awe at what is happening here now. In 2012, wonderful new energies are coming in. 33 cosmic portals throughout the planet are opening. They are each connected with different stars and are bringing in stellar connections and light. They also bring in the Christ light, which is the light of unconditional love. And as they open, they will dramatically affect the surrounding areas. In addition, it's important to recognize that London is the Earth star chakra of the planet. So it's no surprise that the Olympic Games are going to be held there in 2012. The planetary Kundalini is held there. And when it rises, in 2012, and the 12 spiritual chakras of the planet open, then the stellar gateway of the planet, which is in the Arctic, will also open and it will connect to Source. So that everybody will be bathed in source light. It promises to be an amazing energetic opportunity. As most people know, there are two cosmic moments coming. The first is on the 11th of November 2011 at 11:11. Now, 11:11 is a very important cosmic number. It was set in the collective consciousness eons ago. It was set before Atlantis, before Lemuria, even before Mu. And it heralds a new beginning at a higher level. And so, at that moment in 2011, it is anticipated that many people at the third dimension we'll make a shift into the fourth dimension. At that moment, their heart centers will open. And when your heart is open, you want peace. You no longer want war or problems. You just want everyone to live in harmony. You also start to understand the journey of your soul. so that people will start connecting with their own ancient wisdom and getting a much higher perspective on life. It is then expected that those currently in the fourth dimension will move into the fifth dimension. And we need a huge number of people in the fifth dimension to move the planet forward. Those at the fifth dimension will automatically want to create peace and harmony in places where there's imbalance. Lots of people will want to address the poverty and economic imbalances in the world. And then, many who are currently in the fifth dimension will move into ascension. Now, I don't mean disappearing in a puff of light. I mean they will bring source light down, and they will carry this much higher energy, and they will be beacons for the rest of the world. Of course, some will choose to pass over and help from the other side, but many would prefer to stay here and shine their light. And then in 2012, at 11:11, on the 21st of December 2012, is the cosmic moment we're all expecting. A cosmic moment is a moment when the portals of heaven open. There is total silence throughout the universes. And in that moment, extraordinary, miraculous things can happen. And it is anticipated that the planet will shift. So the 12 spiritual chakras will open. The 33 cosmic portals will open. And in my book, 2012 and Beyond, there is information about each one and the impact it will have on the planet. And there are maps showing where they are and how you can access the energy of them. In addition, one of the crystal skulls from Atlantis is going to surface. I describe in my book, Discover Atlantis, how the high priests and priestesses of the golden age of Atlantis, the time when the energy has been the highest it's ever been on the planet, when all the people, especially the high priests and priestesses, had the most awesome gifts and talents and used them only for the highest good. And they fashioned 12 crystal skulls. They were computers. Within each skull was programmed the history of that particular tribe, all their knowledge and wisdom, and as well as that, the origins of humankind. so that we would always have them. The information from the 12 crystal skulls was programmed into an amethyst skull. And this was taken right out of incarnation. So when they left Atlantis, the priests and priestesses took with them the 12 crystal skulls, where they were placed in a safe place where we couldn't access them. The Mayan skull has already returned to humanity. And in 2012, the Incan skull will surface. Now, this will be found by its keepers, who will recognize its sacredness and will look after it. And although it will not be on general awareness or view, people will be able to access the information more readily, and it will have a profound impact on the planet.